are you today? I am so excited to be here on this Sunday with you. If you're new, welcome. And if you've been here before, welcome back to Canyon Hills Presbyterian Church's Sunday School. This is so exciting. We get to do this online. As you can tell behind me, I'm at my home, and that's what's so fun. You're at your home, or maybe at your grandparents or an aunt and uncle's, watching Sunday School. We're still not at church together, and that is okay, because we get to be together online every Sunday. And this Sunday, I have my friend Miss Malia doing the story. Now, we're still learning about Job, and Job's had some very hard times that we've learned. But this week, we're learning just how much hope Job still has through God. That he knows in his heart that there is a light at the end of the tunnel. That kind of sounds funny, a light at the end of the tunnel. Well, that'd be like a train going through a long tunnel and you're hoping you get to the other end. Well, you see the light, you see the sunlight, or you see lights out the tunnel. So that's like this. Job sees the light of God at the end of all this through his hope, even though he's very sad and he doesn't understand why he's going through all this. But with his hope in God, it makes his heart feel good. And he knows it's going to be okay. There will be a light at the end of that tunnel. Also, if you didn't know, Miss Malia is a doctor. Not the kind of doctor that you go and see because you're sick. She's the kind of doctor that teaches doctors. So you know what she did? She wrote a book for kids. It's a kid book on how to be healthy. So she's going to tell you a little bit about that, how eating right, exercising, sleeping good, not playing on the computer too much, how those things can be good for you is awesome, because she wrote it for kids, which is just fabulous. So today, I want you to put on your listening ears and open up your heart to hear the story more about Job and how he will have hope. Hope with the light at the end of the tunnel, which is God. And today, instead of a science project, which I hope you guys have been trying to do those at home, I'm going to do an art project. Now, I'm not an artist, but I do like to have fun with art. So you don't have to be perfect. You can just have fun with art. So when I come back after this story about Job from Miss Malia, and of course, our singing, our dancing, I hope you're learning on that, because we are going to do it for the church very soon. So we'll be able to tape everybody and remind your moms and dads more pictures and more videos so that we can put them with the stories on Sunday. So after that, I'll be back with our art project. So let's calm down, fold our hands, and close our eyes and say, dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for these children that have come to learn more about Job and how he has so much hope in his heart with you. I just pray that they hear the story with their ears and their heart, and they understand it through you. In Jesus' name, amen. So be a good listener for Miss Malia, and I'll be back after. Bye.
Hi friends, how are you today? I'm so excited to be doing your children's story today for a Bible study at Canyon Hills, and I have my friends with me here. What's your name? That means Drew. And what's your name? That means Quinn. I've got Drew and Quinn with me, and Isla. Can we pan over to Isla? Say hi. today we are going to be continuing our story with Job. And I know Mrs. Consolvi talked to you last week about Job and his hard times that he had in his life. So Job was a very, very wealthy man. That means he had a lot of things and beautiful children and a great family. And when Jesus and Satan were talking, they decided that Satan said to God that the only reason that Job loved God was because he had all these things. And so Satan took away all of Job's things. So if we look at these marshmallows here, do they look good to you guys? Yeah. You know what happened to Job is that Satan took away his children. You really want that, don't you? Job really loved his children and all his wealth. Satan took away his animals and all his wealth. Oh no, we really want to eat that marshmallow, but guess what? Satan took away all of his friends and his money and everything. And how do you think that Job felt?
Sad.
Sad. But do you think that he still had faith in God? That he was there?
Yes.
Do you think, yes, that's right. Do you think that God took these, or Satan took these things away to see if Job would still feel Christ in his heart? Yeah, and he did. So he knew that Christ was always in his heart. So when he had all these things, he had lots of money and animals and family, right? He had God in his heart. And then when they all went away, even though he wanted them so badly in his life, like you guys wanted those marshmallows, he still had God in his heart. So God kind of proved Satan wrong, right? So when things happen in your life, like there's the marshmallows, right? And you really want to eat those marshmallows, right? What happens if something in your life happens that's really, really hard and all of the things that you want go away? Did God do that because he doesn't love you? No. God doesn't do things like that in our lives because he doesn't love us. What he does is that he wants us to know that no matter how bad things get, no matter how many times the marshmallows go away, he's always in our heart. He's always with us. And it's when things get hard, that's when we need to feel him in our hearts the most, right? So do you feel God in your heart right now with all these marshmallows gone away? Yeah? Do you have faith in your hearts that maybe God will bring those marshmallows back?
Yes.
Do you think so? What, can you tell me something, Quinn, that's in your heart that allows you to know that God is there?
I was thinking about that because mm-hmm. I knew he was no man. I don't know.
Do you feel his love in your heart?
Yes.
Yeah, what are some of the ways that you think God shows you love?
To be nice.
Yeah. Are your friends nice to you?
Yes.
That's a way to show God's love, yeah. And sometimes when you're feeling sad, do your friends stay by you? Yeah. All right, so now we're starting to eat the crumbs off the table. So maybe I should bring those marshmallows back. We've spent a little time having faith in our hearts that the marshmallows might come back, okay? And that is a really great message today, is that sometimes things are really good, like Job had a really great life and children and animals and wealth and friends. And then when they all got taken away, he still had God in his heart, and he still had love in his heart, and he knew that God wouldn't fail him. And you know what happened? In the end, God brought back to him family, wealth, and love, and friendship. And those are some of the most important things in life. So we have to have faith in our hearts, like Job, that when times get hard, we always, always, always have God with us. And you know what? That makes those hard times better. All right. Do you have faith in your heart that the marshmallows will come back? Do you think they will?
Yes.
Can we say a prayer to God and ask for the marshmallows to come back?
Yes.
Dear God in heaven, we know that you're always in our hearts. We know that you're always with us. When times are good, we thank you for the good things. And when times get hard and we get confused and sad or angry, we know that you're still in our heart. And we know that you'll always be there. We know that you'll always be with us. And we picture you holding our hand when things are hard. And then when things get good again, we thank you because we know that you'll always bring us back. And we know that those marshmallows are going to appear back on the plate and you get to eat them. Amen. Here's a Quinn marshmallow. And what do you say?
Thank God.
Thank you, God, for being in our hearts. Everybody has a wonderful Sunday. Thank you for joining us in this glorious day. We want to thank Drew and Quinn, my props and actors, and the sticky bag of marshmallows that we resurrected that are a little damp but still good. And if you want to play your own game, we thought of another game. You know what you can do? Is if you want to get a balloon and blow it up, and throw it in the air and play catch with your friends, we have so much fun. But another thing you can do is try and get a balloon with no air in it. And try and play catch with that. What do you think would happen if you tried to play catch with a balloon with no air in it?
It would be
fall down.
It would be hard to throw.
It would be really hard, right? And the same thing is true. The balloon that has filled with air, that's like your heart full of God's love and God's comfort in your heart. And we can always keep that up in the air. But the balloon with no air in it, it's like a heart with no God in it. It's just not as fun, and it's not as enjoyable to play with, and it's just not a great part of our lives. So we really need to remember to keep God in your heart, keep it lifted up, keep your smile on, and enjoy the day. Thanks for being with us, and thanks to Drew and Quinn. Yay! Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
touching the floor. Whoa! Okay, and then when I count to three, we're gonna jump up all together as high as you can. You guys ready? One, two, three.
With all my heart.
Story. Finding out that Job still had so much hope. Hope in his heart. That he saw the light at the end of the tunnel that was God. That's a fabulous story for all of us. When we're sad, when we're in trouble, when we have really hard homework, sometimes it's nice to quiet and pray to God and ask for that hope and that light at the end of the tunnel so that we know in our hearts it will be better. We know through God. And I hope you got lots of good exercise with the music, because that's always fun and moving around, because I know you guys got lots of energy. Me, little energy more in the morning. Gotta walk the puppy that I showed you last week, Bucky. So, this week, instead of a science project, I thought we'd do some art projects. I printed the word hope out on a piece of paper. And if you have a printer at home, I know you can ask your moms and dads if they can print out some things that you can color. My son just got a new great big box of colored pencils. So that really works good on this sign, hope, because remember, God is what gives us hope in all things. So we can print those out or different pictures if your moms and dads have them. The other thing I thought we'd do today, and I'm going to move it around a little bit and kind of tilt it down so you can kind of see what I'm doing. What I thought was fun is I grabbed a few things out of the refrigerator and out of my flowers. I had some flowers. I took an apple. I have a few grapes, a carrot I cut the end off on, and a piece of celery that I also did. I dropped one of my grapes. So I thought it'd be fun to see how these make prints on paper. So I have this big yellow piece of paper, and I'm gonna see what these make on there. Now, unfortunately, I don't have any paintbrushes at home. I just realized they're at church. So that's okay. I have a spoon, a little back of a spoon. And I thought I'd just take one of the flowers. And flowers have all kinds of different petals and a little fun, kind of hard middle. And I thought maybe I would just put a little bit of this. It's kind of a green, maybe has a little blue in it. Just kind of put it around on the flower like that. And then I'm just going to press it onto the paper. Let's see what I get. Ooh, that's kind of pretty. And I think I'll do it one more time with not as much paint on it because I just got a lot off. So we're going to do this and touch it. It's kind of pretty. Do a couple flowers. Then maybe if I got a green pencil out, I could make some stems. That's kind of pretty, just with the flower. And then I thought I'd do celery. Celery kind of makes a U shape, but it's got also little edges on it. So I don't want to put too much on here, so I'm just gonna maybe dip this in the purple paint, but kind of wipe it off a little bit. And let's see, I got a little bit of purple paint on there. And let's see, maybe I'm trying to make some leaves on my flowers. Oh, that turned out okay. There we go. They could be little flower, little leaves, or maybe they're purple worms on my flower. But I think that's kind of cute. So let's see, what else do I have here? I have a grape. And so I thought it'd be kind of fun. I'm gonna put my paper now onto a tray. And I'm gonna dip this in, let's go with red this time so you can really see it. I'm gonna get the red all over the grape. So it's all over the grape and kind of on my fingers, but that's okay. And I'm gonna roll it around on this tray and see what I can get. So if I keep rolling it past some of the paint, I get a little more paint. I just thought that was kind of, that's another, using a grape. Kind of looks like a bug or a, let's see, let's bring it up closer. A bug with the flowers. It's kind of fun. That's a fun one too. Now the apple, I'm gonna wipe my fingers off. And moms and dads have to do this. Kind of has a little star right here. So I am going to just kind of cut it a little bit. See if that star will show up a little bit more if I put some lines in here. We'll see. There. Okay, and I think I'm gonna do this that green again. I'm just gonna kind of put it on the apple. And what's neat is it's got a little bit of texture on there. So it's gonna make a really cool print, I think. Let's see. So I'm gonna put it at the top. I'm going to press. Let's see what we got. Oh, maybe I didn't get it on hard enough. But that's pretty cool. You got a little bit of texture. You can make another flower out of it, make a bug out of it, maybe even a dinosaur. I mean, I was even thinking, like, this looks like a bee, and we can make a dinosaur, but all kinds of things. So I just put the paint right on there. Now, you don't want to eat it. Don't want to eat it. And then I have my carrot. I'm just gonna dip the carrot in a dark blue and kind of make maybe a center for this flower. And maybe a little bit more, maybe a little more on that one. And, oh, I could make a, how about a centipede or a millipede or a caterpillar? Kind of do that. And then maybe with one of my pencils, I can draw little antennas on here. And maybe a little bit darker one, I can put all the little legs, because a centipede and a millipede have lots and lots of legs. So there you go.
Honey got the hat.
A lot of fun. I did all mine on one paper, but you don't have to. You can do them on different papers. And I have one more that I think you're really going to like. I have a black piece of paper. Or you could use a dark navy or just a darker color of paper, or a white piece of paper with darker paint. But I am gonna use a little bit of my purple and green. I'm gonna kind of mix it up, and I don't know if you can see. I've got my colors right here. And I'm going to add a little bit of water because I want it to be a little bit liquidy. So I'm going to kind of mix that up right there. And you got to have your moms and dads help you a little bit, just so we don't get paint all over your clothes, huh? Because I don't want to get them all over my clothes, so I know you don't either. And I'm going to kind of just drop it onto the page a little bit, just like that. So it kind of looks like little sprinkles, little splashes. Here, I'll show you. See, just like that. Now what I'm gonna do, which I think is so cool, I'm gonna lift up, see if you can see it. I'm gonna use a straw. And you know how you use a straw in a drink, you suck your drink in? Well, this time we're gonna blow through the straw. So we're gonna. See, and you can make it fan out. Make it look like different things. I think I'm going to add a little more water because I want to really go far. So let's see if I can add a little more water to my paint. Just like that. I'm going to stir it around my paper a little bit. And let's see what happens when I add a little bit, if it'll go further. So see if you can see it. See how it spreads around? So if it's really liquidy, it's going to spread more. And if it's not, doesn't have as much water, it's going to be flatter. But I just think that is so cool that you can just blow and make a really cool picture. So I just left this with some cool things that you might have at home. Have your moms and dads, like maybe go out in the backyard and you can pick up leaves and grass and pine cones, all kinds of stuff that you can make different designs. I just got everything out of my refrigerator today and made that. And then with the paint and blowing with the straw. So just some fun things you can do this summer. Remember, take pictures and videos because we really want to see you and put you with our videos. So right before we go, let's calm ourselves, fold our hands, and close our eyes and say, dear God, thank you. Thank you for hope. Thank you for that light at the end of the tunnel that we know is you. I pray that these children have a fun and safe week until we come back together next Sunday. In Jesus' name, amen. I hope you have a fabulous week. Have fun. Do some art projects. Even if you don't do these, see if Mom and Dad will take a picture so I can see what you're doing. And then maybe I can teach others what you're doing too. So until next time, you have a fabulous week. And always tell Mom and Dad,